from class sixth class, and he's saying it's a universal language. Okay. Interesting language in what sense? He's quite comfortable at this point.
Once you become a doctor and now you want to go to urban areas, they are Hyderabad, and you want to serve there, neither you want to push off to America, it's not like that. You are going to promise me today that you are going to do it in rural areas, right? Okay, let us start the...
Okay, chalo.
How do you feel you can do this job?
How do I feel right now?
Right now.
So, if I give you uniform right now, okay, and I say you are an IPS officer, and I make you sit there in my chair, and you have a lot of people in all your ground. Inspectors, DSPs, ASPs, and you know, all your force in front of you, 400 to 500 people sitting there. How do you feel?
I'm so happy.
Elated, no? So powerful. So every moment I feel that.
Before coming to this profession, your profession is doctor. But why you choose this profession?
Yeah, it's a very good question. It's always my interest that has given me. I want all the kids to listen to what I'm saying. Whatever interests you, you should go and achieve it. As you say, I was of that age, then I thought, you know, I want to become a teacher. Because in a classroom when I sit and when I see the teacher is the most powerful being there, you know, molding the minds, and I had this impression that she can control my parents also. If, because the parents, what they do, if you do something, I tell you a teacher. Right.
Yes.
So I wanted to become a teacher. And when I saw a doctor like you, I wanted to become a doctor because he's curing people and I have fever and within a few days, or within I think an hour also he can control the fever. So I felt he's so powerful. He has magic in his hands. So I wanted to become a doctor. So every phase, you know, you should dream a lot like that. Now you get exposed to many things. You know? You'll dream yourself as an Einstein.
Yeah.
Or you can dream as, you know, a rocket launcher or landing on the moon. Yeah. As a pilot. Yeah. And as an astronaut, as a big artist or cinema actor or a big player.
So then invariably, if I want to know about the body, it is the medicine.
Women-related issues, because the healing of women, looking at the pathogen situation that she is in, and when I was working in government hospital also, as you said, people I would like to, you know, give service to them. So, like you, and you know, a bigger platform. So I thought civil is the best one, yeah? So I can, you know, maybe change the face of one entire district. So I can fight against the crime against women. Right? So that's how I landed here. Okay, did I answer your question?
Yes.
So it is your interest that drives you. You should daydream. Let me tell you. Okay, dream. And then you know somewhere it triggers, you know, you like yourself seeing like that only. Sometimes like pilot only. All the time, whatever people say, you should become an engineer, you should become a doctor. No. I said, no, I dream like pilot only because you're so fascinated. You and somehow it is ingrained in your mind, you know, that is something very magical for you. So that is the reason why you want to become and it should get fixed. And then, you know, it is all the mind that drives you. You should enjoy everything that comes on your way. That's it. Just don't take any tension, pressure, nothing. Okay?
What is the most interesting thing have you done in your career?
In my
career?
I've just started my career, so every day I do, I find such very good, interesting things. But because that you have asked, so I've rescued a 6 days old girl baby, okay, who was kidnapped from a maternity hospital, okay, and it has happened in Hyderabad. So just baby was born, just she is 6 days old and she was there just beside the mother. And then the kidnapper, she's a lady also. She has come and she said, I want to get your baby vaccinated. I belong to the hospital staff. And she ran away with the baby. So we got a complaint. We rushed to the spot and then we saw the mother. The mother was in complete tragedy. So we had our own ways of getting the baby. I felt very sad at that particular moment. We cannot even imagine the kind of the sorrow that she was in at that moment. So we went and got the baby from either Karnataka. She kidnapped and she went and said that throughout the night the rescue operation was headed by me and family, my team of course. I have guided them. So it was like literally like my own baby I've lost. So it was like that. So throughout the night we were speechless, we were on the roads and investigated it thoroughly, looking into every CCTV plane and you know. And finally, we placed her in Karnataka in Kudos. I had this, you know, the kind of a goal and, you know, the commitment that I should get her, the baby, small baby. It was so apprehensive what will happen to the baby because in Kudos, there is black magic everywhere. So they usually put the human sacrifice for the sake of their own benefits and all. You got my point, right? They have this false belief that if they, you know, sacrifice a baby, then I live for 100 years or so. So that kind of practice is quite there in that particular part of the Karnataka either. So I was very apprehensive that they would lose the baby also. Undercover, we do many operations as such. We should not be doing it. Because we are undercover, we cannot uncover it.
He is asking a very intelligent question.
Yeah, yeah. He's already into, you know, that mode.
Yes.
Police officer, detective and all, you know. Yes. Experience?
This job.
It offers everything. It's about man management, planning, being tricky. You have to anticipate also, and you should be tough with some people, you should be very humane and empathetic with some people, you should be able to understand the human psyche. So there are many things in it, many, many things in it. But,
you need some suggestion.
First of all, what's your age?
My age is 15
years. You must be 9th class or something, right? The question first of all is, why do you want to become an IS officer?
To serve the nation.
So she also wants to serve the nation. She wants to become a real IS. Is that high point? So first
I inspired her. That IS inspired her.
Okay, so that is an IS officer, not an IS officer. Yes, that is IS officer. Okay, fine. Either IPS or IAS, you got inspiration, please carry on. Because we have to get to see, you know, very few people soon we are get inspired nowadays. It's very hard to find some people so inspirational. Let me put it in. If you feel you have to become, you can become. You have to very hard. Okay? So you can become a business manager. That should be very, very strong and it will drive. That's it. You need not worry about anything. Okay? You do your studies properly and then you can dedicate to whatever fascinates you, just go and pursue it. Okay? Now itself, it's not advisable to give you a lot of guidance. You need to get to blossom as you are. And once you cross the way, then it starts the preparation. Then you can come down to me and ask me how to do it. And I'll model it. Now, where did you remember? So, life for me, every day, every minute is a turning, every second is a turning point. turning points, brakes, nothing like that, you know, or U-turns, nothing like that. People say, you know, generally people ask in their interviews, you know, because you're this thing, are they born? Nothing. I don't think every moment, every second gives the job, an opportunity to do work. Okay, every minute you have to take a job, you have to choose something, right? So whether you come here or not, the precious time and many other things. There's an option you have and you have chosen it. So every minute, every second you have to take decisions. How do you take your decision? Every second can be a turning point. Right?
Okay.
What's your best
recommendation
in this
information?
best moment. Every time somebody comes with a cool background or anybody, and I like, you know, kind of just use it really well. There's so lot of them. And I inspire people also. Every moment is the best moment. If you want to become the one, you know, if you become the one you wanted to become, then every moment will become the best moment. That's what a dancer, you know, or a painter, you know, when she does it, every moment is the best moment. When she is dancing, every moment is a when you play a cricket, hello, you have fun every time you hit the ball. Whether it goes to six or that's the after effect. But when you are hitting, come on, put it with, you know, a complete passion and, you know, complete involvement, hello.
What is your experience in asking her? Here we came now, man, and asking me questions, man. What is, how do you feel now?
I always love interacting with people like you. It's nice, you know, that people are looking up to you. It's obviously nice. It's obviously very nice. You want to sit for a moment in this chair when I ask you the questions. Shall I? How do you feel?
I feel happy. I feel
happy because I am an IPS officer. No, imagine yourself as an IPS officer. Now you have become an IPS officer. Now I've come. Your name is?
I'm Vinay.
Vinay. So I'm Vinay. You are Chetana. Okay? Okay, Vinay, IPS officer. Okay? Dr. Vinay, I guess. Okay? Okay? You should say just yes. I'll ask you the questions. Okay? Sir, which is the case where you have felt that you have done really good to the people? Which case? Some case you narrate.
When I rescue someone, I feel very happy in that rescue mission.
Who inspired you to become an IPS officer?
All the teachers and the staff in the school encouraged me and they were like, and they the help of online.
Then, you know, 400 and odd policemen are saluting you. How do you feel, sir? Okay, so anybody else who want to ask, he is into the role now.
Come yes.
Have you ever hold a weapon, sir? Weapon, gun? No? Okay. So if you have a gun, how do you feel?
I feel very excited.
So I have all those emotions. So you want to become a police officer? Very nice interacting with you. Okay, I had fun. I don't know whether how much did I, you know, share my moments or, you know, my knowledge, the knowledge that I have. I don't know whether I've confused you more or I don't know. But I had complete fun. I'm as elated as he is.
Who is your strength?
I think me only.
Your parents and how do you feel?
How do you feel if you stay in a hostel?
Very so sad.
I'm not here. No? So even I feel very sad if my parents are not here, my family is not here. And sometimes my job is so good that they're not, it doesn't give me a space to think about it. So in the weekends I remember them and they'll be there at the doorsteps. Come out and you have to do your studies. You have to study. The same thing for me also.
and education.
I should say everything, you know, I should not confess.
Okay, sometimes I used to like some subjects, sometimes I used to hate the boring lectures, You know, sometimes the teachers were just so interesting and they used to teach it as if they should be a big DJ in front of us. The DJ itself used to be like that. It's really, you know, and I used to grasp and I used to come to read. All the time, I'd say, whatever, how are you spending your day? I used to spend your day like that. Maybe you're a very good child, and I was not so brilliant as you are.
Did you get any advice for this professional work?
Advice?
Not yet. I'm feeling bad now.
As usual, a lot of all those things which I get only after 10 years of service. So I'm just starting my service and I'm quite far away from those events. That's it. Did you enjoy speaking to me?
Yes.
Did you understand?
Yes.
Yes? It's very entertaining. You entertained me a lot. Thank you so much. So, what's your parents?
My father's
auto driver.
His name is Anjagan. Mm-hmm. And my mother is an Amlo. Mm-hmm. And she works as a small kind of officer in JHMC.
Okay.
Now she is the now she resigned the job. Mm-hmm. And she is staying home and is nothing but she is housekeeper.
Oh yeah, homemaker. Very nice.
My father's name is KCU Numeran. My father is farmer. Mm-hmm. My mother name is K Bunji. My mother is housewife. Mm-hmm.
You're from which part of the state?
Medak.
Medak. You? Kondapur.
My father is a farmer, my dad, my mom working as a human and got us. I'm from Mundu.
Mundu.
Yes, ma'am.
I think that you are asking me about what is your school
education. Oh, no. Okay. You have answered properly now. Don't worry about it. Next.
My father's name is Janaya. My mother's name is Ishwaramma. Mm-hmm. Both are the tailors and mother is housemaker.
My father's name is Satyanarayana. My mother's name is Renka. My father's occupation is painter. My mother's occupation is farmer. And I have one sister. My sister's name is Dikshita. He's studying 10th.
You're from?
I'm from Cherial.
My father's name is Sheshachiran, he is farmer. My mother's name is Sushila, he is nurse. I am from 2 Point School, Medak district.
My name is Lathasri and my father's name is Mangalappa, my mother's name is Venkatamma. Both are farmers. I'm from this Elsanpalli Madhur school. My village Elsanpalli.
Madhur.